We're here at Don't Ever Bank Your Field in Cracksumskull, Florida. Come here for the retirement, stay here for the drive-through funeral services. Getting buried has never been so quick and easy.
I wouldn't mind taking a dirt nap here, although my dream for years has been to be soaked in rum, then thrown into a volcano. I like the idea of going out with a bang.
This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the MFL. The teams storm the field. The Blitzburg Steelheads battle the Cracksumskull Jugulars. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pink flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And it's 1st and 10. Quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's 1st and 10. And the quarterback throws a murder ball, which will slice its way through any defensive. And like Rex's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. First and two. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's 1st and 10. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. It's a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
2nd down and 5. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and ten. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
First and four. And the crowd goes wild! Touchdown! Touchdown! Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
First and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. He turned into a mutant fireball with that flame on dirty trick. And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten. The receiver's open, so the QB just threw the ball away.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Oh, man, the defense brought a sack lunch today. Hey, hey, don't eat him. Not until he's cooked. Third down and the QB is saying his prayers. Pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. Ooh. do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt with, oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Oh, he just got crushed. And that'll bring up second and 1.
A great throw and a great catch.
Yeah, but pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. This guy is making a name for himself tonight with a pickup of about 10 on that play.
Hey, he makes up a name for himself every night. That's how he stays ahead of the bounty hunters. He's wanted in 50 states.
It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Second down and inching. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the key.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they both wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
Second down, the and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and long. Third down and the offense needs a miracle.
Way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten.
I personally think the ginormous guy is compensating for something.
They get their hands up and block the pass. Second down and ten.
You idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is... I forgot my point.
And it's first and ten. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. Second down and ten. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down. And it's first and ten. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up second and one. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
And big deal. Mr. Meat for Brain grabbing a ball and didn't fall down.
Well, that should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Sticky ball, dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend. I didn't. I love this job. Second down and more than the QB would like. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Third down and, well, good luck. Man, what a hit that was. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. That was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And it's first and 10. And that is caught for a first down. They use their second timeout, but they are running out of time.
Pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. The quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. Second down in a very lot. And then Cats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
Second down and a lot. And he'll throw that one out of bounds. They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Mom Satan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
Wow, I take a beast boost injection too.
Now that is weird side effects, Bricks. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Yeah. Well, why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my fault. But Brits can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
And QB threads the needle for 2 points. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10.
Threatened to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's 1st and 10. And they call it an enormous dirty trick. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Down and long. Now it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
3rd down and long. God, he's still got his leg. He's gonna need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a sawbuck says he misses.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
It's 1st and 10.
Jerk. Ain't nothing worse than wasting a good explosive.
2nd down and 10. And that'll give them 4 more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's 1st and 10. And the defense jumps outside, trying to mutilate the QB. If he was still talking, he'd be saying, psycho killer, qu'est-ce que c'est? What the fuck? And it's 1st and 10. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and three.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot. Hot. Hot.
He did it! He scores! And with that amazing run, he burst through the end zone for six. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a turn here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he...
Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and ten. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Second down and 10. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. Third and four. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And he snags the punt and looks for... Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two.
Guys like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot. 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 Hot.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot, 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 hot.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
Put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nice.
Hey, Briggs, check the rule book.
Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
The teams have kept each other at bay for now. But there's still plenty of time to bribe refs and kill the other team's star players, so it's anyone's game, really, Bricks. Second down and more. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
Hot one, hot two.
No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peckerhead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Third down and forever.
Hot one.
And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. A misfired punt will give the opposing team great fit. And he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very long. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Man, these guys have metal balls. They're going to try to pick up the first down here.
Do they jingle when they run?
They clank him.
Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball.
That's a little on the nose, don't you think? That's sort of how they take it to the air and pick up a fourth down conversion. I thought they were crazy to go for it.
Well, they still might be bricks, but crazy works in the MFL sometimes. Other times, it just comes back with a shotgun. And it's first and 10. And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. Blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game fire modes. I mean,
you ever have a bottle of hot sauce shoved up your ass?
Quite the description of that painful hit, Junior.
Huh? No, it's a question here on this online dating profile. It doesn't say if on purpose or by accident. I'll leave a blank.
Oh, with a punishing hit. Second down in a mile.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And it's first and 10. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
First and 4. Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Boom! And it's first and 10.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 3.
Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and one.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and ten. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and four. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And the 2-minute warning sounds. There's not much time left at all. And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times.
And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Second down and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two.
Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crabapple Trees, Bricks.
You're telling.
Well, that's two timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time, and I have mastered it.
It's about a 3-yard pickup. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! I like this. They're going for two. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and ten. Up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one open, Bricks.
Yeah, and I nearly married Trim.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Second down in inches. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and ten. That'll be their final timeout. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. Good night, Irene.
You ever get the face with a shovel, Graham?
I have. And trust me, the hit that guy just took was worse.
And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
The Cracksumskull Jugulars took their city's name to heart and win the game. They handed the opposition a crushing defeat with a 2-point win. Man, talk about a close one.
Speaking of close, do you ever wonder why razor blades need 5 blades? I get a close shave just fine with one of those cheap travel razors, don't you, Graham?
No idea what you're talking about. Let's hear what the MVP has to say about this victory. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...